What is good, fam? It is your boy Chimizay, back at it again with another album review, going back to back this week. Yeah, I'm on my ground right now. So today we're gonna be reviewing, reacting to Injury Reserve's album titled, self-titled album, Injury Reserve. I know I'm like 2 weeks behind, but I don't know. I've been slacking. I'm just gonna be honest, I've been slacking, but I'm here and I'm gonna do it. I was about to just say, you know, I'm gonna just listen to it by myself, but nah, I've waited 2 weeks, so I might as well get my reaction to it. Injury Reserve, they are a three-man group coming out of, I wanna say, Arizona, maybe Phoenix, I don't know, but it's somewhere in Arizona. And they dropped an album 2016, I think, from the dentist's office or something. Apparently that they recorded it like by a dentist's office or whatever. That's irrelevant. But I only like maybe two songs off of it, to be honest. But then they dropped Floss. Pretty good album. I liked it. It was very raw in the production. The rapping as well. It was very just very grimy and dirty, but also kind of experimental with the production. A lot of different, like, kind of I don't know, industrial noises. I don't know if that's the correct term, but I liked it. Very gritty, and I need to go to a live show of theirs. Actually, they just announced their tour, and I'm gonna cop tickets on Friday. But yeah, because I've seen some live footage from their shows, and they go off. Like, I think their music, like, just listening it, like, in my car or through my headphones is already hard, but man, they go off live. So yeah, I'm really excited for this album. It's been 2 years since their last album, so they probably spent 2 years on this. It got some notable features in it: Rico Nasty, JPEG Mafia, who I believe they toured together last year, and Freddie Gibbs, Amine. So without further ado, this is Injury Reserve. Let us get into it. Karuna Lime. Karuna and Lime is the first song. Wait, I think this is a music video. I think I've heard the song before. Never thought I'd be getting paid off for these rhymes. Ain't it funny sometime how things align? Let the fans that say we don't get enough shine. Shit. That production is wild. Alright. Next song is Jawbreaker. I like that. It was a good opener. I like the production as well, mostly. I didn't like the first verse. Second verse was better for sure though. Alright. And I think they dropped a music video for this one as well. But that was a while ago.
New goddamn Instagram. Y'all niggas seen these Instagram pages where they literally tell you the whole entire outfit and the price range from head to toe, nigga?
Yeah.
So today
he sold in, not spiked up. I do what I want, not whatever gets the likes up. They don't like my outfit, but they like the outcome. You never see any shoes, well, that's the reason,
yeah.
I need them. They copy my swag. You can see that I taught them fresh to death.
I don't know, it's weird. It's weird because the production is so lo-fi. Get your shit together, get your jaw up. And very chill. How come you're staring? I love it. I like it. Yo, this will go wild live. Wow.
Get your shit together, get your jobs off the
Alright.
Get the fuck up!
Whoa, hold up, before we get into all of that. I like that. I like the Jawbreaker. That was nice. It was good. It was weird. Like it sounded like some like old like Japanese kind of production that they sampled, maybe where it got influenced from, and very chill. And I like their verses were pretty great as well. Rico Nasty is a great feature, and I guess Proteins was the person doing the hook. Pretty great, and I love that, like, that drop. Did not expect that whatsoever. But next song is GTFU featuring JPEG Mafia and Cake the Killer. I believe Cake the Killer was featured on a song On Floss. I don't remember which one, but it's one of the really good ones for sure. Is my body ready? No, but here we go.
Fuck boy, get the fuck up. Get up off your ass. Get the fuck up. This is fresh rap to me. Yep, and when no time for the link up, readjust my rhythm so these listeners could keep up. I'ma give you calls to turn around and try to send me. Bitch, I made a way for you faggots to get your money. Link them to win a mess crop when the sunny. Can't afford to act funny when you get into the money. Yo, what's up, nigga? Simon Says doors open, don't let the truck, nigga. Talking your chain, throw bows in a function. If a nigga ain't like it, tell him back up, nigga.
Oh.
Get back, nigga. I ain't really fucking wake. None of these rap cover bands looking like clowns, little nigga.
That was wild. JPEG didn't even come in yet. Man, I love that glitchiness. Like very industrial, I believe it's the term is industrial sound.
Get the fuck out,
did I miss JPEG Mafia's part? What? Wait, I gotta go back. Did I miss his part? So I guess he had that, 10 second intro. What, bro, where's my verse? What? Well, it still went hard as hell. That was pretty wild. And that switch up too. I think this might be a really good album. I think this is gonna be a good album. QWERTY interlude.
Couldn't fix damage. I'm trying to make a dollar rolling up with CD.
Hold on, I keep skipping.
All right. Jailbreak the Tesla featuring Amine. Amine. Anime. Yeah, I think I saw the...
Jailbreak the Tesla.
Yeah. I saw the music video to this as well.
Break the Tesla.
It's like, it's so futuristic and dirty as well. I love it.
Fuck it, jailbreak the Tesla.
Job like mine, powdered in tune. Face need the Curtis. I'm a black James Bond, so I make them nervous. Yo, engine go boom, and my engine go.
All right, I like the production. Well, I don't know. Actually, I thought the production on that was a little too not redundant, but like just too repeating itself too much. And I did not like the hook. I don't like the jailbreak the Tesla. I mean, you can start off maybe in the intro saying that, but I don't know. I feel like the hook needs to provide something more. But I did like some of the elements. I feel like they sampled like the tire screeching, like while driving. So that's pretty cool. But okay track for me. I think I liked Amine's part first the best for sure. He definitely knows how to like flow on that. And that usually he's not. I mean, he's been diving more into like, I guess, like harder, trappier sounds, but I don't think he's like very accustomed to like this sort of sound. So, and he did pretty well. Next song is Gravy and Biscuits.
Yo, me and you.
Check it.
Yeah, check it. Everything cool, nigga. Everything gravy and biscuits.
Sky over your head ain't safe no more, and this safe place ain't your home.
Would you like to upload this to your cloud?
The blue light's bad for your eyes, little nigga. You won't grab the chrome.
Wasn't feeling the hook that much on that one either. I did like that kind of switch up in the middle there, but.
Step one, choose your drums.
Alright, rap song tutorial.
Step two, assemble your drums.
Gonna teach us how to do a rap song,
Step
huh?
Step four, write a hook.
You can get in line. You can have your own
skis. I ran in my threes on so they don't think I defer. Oh my god. Congratulations. You have made one rap song repeat 10 to 12 times to create a rap album. New choice, got some bread in mind. I
want the two. Hey, so yeah, for all y'all SoundCloud rappers, here's an easy step-by-step process on how to create your first rap song. All right, next song is Wax On featuring Freddie Gibbs. He's supposed to be dropping an album with Madlib soon, which I am hyped for.
Man, I'll stand up for your fate, yeah. Wax on, wax off, wax on, wax
off. That hook is hard. And
yeah.
I can't wait to damn fall to stop now. I hit rock bottom, been on that ground. Always managed to go get back up. Forever on my own, no backup.
Yeah, wait, yeah. And I'm climbing around my own.
All right, Freddy.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Let's go top, yeah, 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 yeah. Spot, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Y'all better not snuff me on my Freddie Gibbs feature. Stove off, stove on, dope on, my stove top, yeah. Percy Miller, ice cream, my glass pot, yeah. Gang gang, world tour, my show's been sold out, yeah. I used to fuck strippers on this stop, yeah. You falling off, the time been in this shit, they can't fuck with the game. Shit to be popping off, shit out of Gary with niggas are keen for fame. Ripping this water off. This song is hard. That flow, yeah, that flow that they keep within like the first, I don't know, like 8 bars or whatever. Hard. I love that.
Wax on, wax.
Dope. I like how the instrumentation was changing the entire time. The production. This is nice. I like that. All right. What a year it's been.
Paychecks, even if my rent's paid for, even if I pay state tax.
I like that glitchiness, man.
Way, way back, grandpa called it chasing the dream, and I can't take that.
Just since when a nigga think I'm to be his pawn, yo, I heard a lot of bullshit within this last year. All chirp, that shit's for the birds. If you ask kids, been a nigga, fuck you, nigga.
Man,
starts fucking up.
That went. I was not expecting that. From within the first 30 seconds, not expecting that. I definitely have to say, like, I really, the similarity between JPEG Mafia and Injury Reserve's production is there for sure. I like it though. Alright, next song is Hello. Or Hello? It's with a question mark and an exclamation mark. Seems like that's just an interlude, just a minute long. Next song is Best Spot in the House.
Check in. I've had niggas that come up to me, say that they look up to me, yeah. And that they've been fucking with me since shit was ugly, yeah. And that these songs, man, they say they life. Now I go to the funeral, telling myself you gotta swallow all the guilt that you did you. Shit was juvenile, like how was I too cowardly to go to your fucking funeral? But still feel like rapping about your death was fucking suitable.
The healthiest dude I know, one day he was hooping and just dropped to the flow. And disbelief, man, I could never fathom that. His sister Rose. He hit me like it might have been a heart attack. Couldn't push. Yeah, that shit was so wild. Seen that ugly ass grand new. I made you proud. Yeah.
Nice story. But I do have to say, kind of his flow was a little, I don't know, kind of shaky there. But that's all I gotta say. Nice song. Good song. Next song is New Hawaii featuring Dram, Tony Velour, and Dylan Brady. I don't know who Tony and Dylan is, but I'm excited for the Dram feature.
Know that I've been on your mind some time. It's one of the things you can't deny. And you know it's sweeter than the previous time. Deeper than I thought I might. Know that I've been on your mind some time. It's one of things you can't deny. And you know.
Well, was not expecting a song like this on this album. The production is also pretty nice. It's very chill, but also still abrasive, like glitchy and industrial.
Know that I've been
but beautiful. I like it.
For you.
There's no sunlight. The dark is not a habitat for me, cause I'm a sunshine. Thinking about somebody who
ain't thought about me. Bro, Dram's voice is so smooth.
Say
so,
you love me to a bitch. Act like it sometimes.
I love it.
You Picasso and our kids. Hoping they more of you and all this love you give. Hoping they meet someone that make them feel like this.
That is nice. I like that. Very, very sentimental. Okay. That's a good it's a good switch up from the rest of the songs for sure. But still definitely fits within the album. And I believe this last song, Three Man Weave.
High school, no repercussions for the shit that I do. Check it, yo. My biggest worries were missing a free throw. Now me, Grogs, and Pete doing the three man weave though. Loves with the panel.
This song kind of reminds me. By the way, I forgot, I didn't mention it. There was Floss, and then they dropped an EP called Drive It Like It's Stolen. This song reminds me like the Ultra from Drive It Like It's Stolen. But continue. Man. Great production.
This reminded nigga of high school. No repo was too pretentious for some egos. Then Fonse made a song with Little Beat Up. Check it. Yo, shit changed. That's some shit that we know. Now me, Grogs, and Pete doing
that's,
the three.
That's
man,
funny
we,
though. I so relate to that. Yeah, too pretentious for Migos. Yeah, I used to be that little, like, pretentious ass kid. Just, this ain't real hip hop. I mean, I think it was before Migos, like 20. I don't know, like when they first blew up, like 2013. Yeah. But, yeah, that's funny. Shout out, Migos.
Oh, this.
That is the end of Injury Reserve's self-titled album, Injury Reserve. So, my first initial thoughts. Great album. I like it. Production is great. Definitely improved upon, like they expanded from their previous songs, like from Floss and Drive It Like It's Stolen. Yeah, it's wild. Like the transitions, the switch ups, the instrumentations added, and the production itself, just like so many wild, weird sounds and samples. I really like it. And I like the fact that they had, you know, they were able to do a slow song and still kind of keep that element about them, like what makes them. It still fit on the album, but it was definitely different. It was slower tempo, and yeah, it just worked. It flowed. And it sounded really nice as well. And yeah, it was really good album. Really great album, actually. I think there might have been two songs that I was not a fan of. Can't remember which one it was. That's I think Gravy and Biscuits. I think that's the only song that I didn't care for. The rest, great, fantastic. Wax On is probably my favorite on there, or GTFU, probably. Though it's between those two. Great songs, just heavy hitting, verses are great, flows A1, and the production again is wild, insane. Really love the direction they're going towards, and I don't see a lot of people have that sound. I'd say the closest one that I know is JPEG Mafia, but even then, like, there's still like a distinct, for me, like a distinct difference between the two. But yeah, check it out for sure. If you're a fan of Injury Reserve, probably already have, because since I'm like 2 weeks late, but that's my reaction. Comment below if you want me to review or react to any other albums that may have come out recently or coming up. I believe like I'm gonna react to Madlib and Freddie Gibbs for sure. And someone had recommended NF's album is coming out next month, so I'll be looking out for that as well. But it's been your boy Chim Is Ye. Peace out.